Hello, this is Talamir, and welcome to another repair video. In this video, we are looking at a headset. And as you can see right here, that is one very, very broken 3.5 millimeter jack. So we need to snip that off, and we got some replacements. They're very nice, very beautiful looking connectors that we got going here. So that's what we're going to be doing in this video. Let's get cracking at it. To begin with, let's just straight up snip this off. I'm going to snip off a little bit more just so that I can match things up a little bit easier. Now with this particular version, this material that goes around the wire, it's just straight up fabric, and underneath we have the actual wire itself. So this is just standard rubberized wire coating. I'm going to snip a little bit of this away, and we're going to get at the underneath. Let's just take this off. You got to go not incredibly deep, but you're looking at pretty much where I've got it there, 3/8 of an inch, maybe a little bit less than that, maybe a spec more. So this right here is just some padding. Okay, so what do we got here? There's one wire. There's another wire. Here's another wire. And here is another wire. At this given point in time, I do not know what these all do. One of them is definitely going to be a ground. And that's actually something you can figure out. And that's why I left some cable remaining behind on here, so that I can take that off there and give me an idea of what's going on. Because this little guy right here is going to match up with this one. So if I can figure out what's going on here, I can figure out what's going on here. Problem is that the wires in here are already broken. Oh no. I can still test it out. I should be able to figure it out. No big deal. Even right here, I do see some wires. Let me see if I can pull this out. Doesn't even matter if I break it. I just need to get in there. I can see there's one copper wire. It's kind of coppery. If I can figure out two of those, I'll be on my way to the rest. Dissect this a little bit, just see what's going on. Okay, so we got that plastic off of there. Can we see anything more? Not really, but I can see what wires are going in there. I can see the copper and not much else. Instead of trying to figure around with that, there's two things I'm gonna do. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to look up the wiring diagram for the 3.5 millimeter. Okay, there it is right there. As you can see, left, right, ground, microphone. So that very bottom one, that's going to be the microphone, and got to connect that one to ground. So that's pretty easy enough for us to solve. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect this into a phone, just play some music, and then we're going to poke around until we figure out what each one of these are. These little pins on the inside. Not all headphone developers have the exact same wiring scheme. I've got this on resistance mode. I'm gonna put it in so that I can hear when there is a beep, that it is indicating there is a clear bridge to ground. And the tip, if you recall correctly, that is your left. So let's poke around and find out if we have one that is showing as left. So I see copper. Nothing showing there. How about that red one? Now they do have a bit of a coating on them, so this doesn't always work. So that's not going to tell us anything at the moment. I'm going to take a guess that this pin right here is the one at the end. There you have it. That is the end. The next one down, it's probably going to be in reverse order, is my guess, because they're going to hive them together. Yeah, there we go. And then the next one. This will be the one at the end. There you go. And that last one, obviously, is going to be ground. So far, so good. I'm going to stick it into this phone that's been recently reset. And we're going to connect up the wires and just see what one does what. Let's find out what wire is what wire. Got to unwrap this one first. Right there. There's our green wire. That means we've got 3, 4, 5 wires. This has only four poles. One of these wires, I don't know, maybe it's maybe the wire on the outside is protection. Might be there to go in and reduce noise. Now to get this to work, I do need both ground and one of the other wires working here. I do see a speck of red in here. Let's bring back my multimeter, see where this is coming from. There it is. The red one is most likely the right ear. That's my theory. I'll stick with that for now. Okay, let's tin this red one now. Very nice. I'm gonna guess that this one right here is probably the left, tinning quite nicely. Most of the work that I've been doing with this kind of stuff hasn't been headsets, but it's mostly been stereo systems when I've been working on sound equipment. This is a bit of a new experience for me. Okay, let's see how that goes. So ground, either one of these should work, whether it's left or right. One at the bottom is the microphone. What? Which one's ground again? Oh, I feel like an idiot. It's the bottom, it's near the bottom. I just find this really confusing that the microphone is this big honking huge thing that I would usually associate with being the ground pin. Left for the tip, right for that one. The third one in is still ground, and the mic is still the very bottom. I'm just going to stick this in here just so that it's got something to be held in by. And let's get these wired in. And there's what I've got going. Turn on some music. I am hearing music. What's annoying me is that it's not... I don't care. Turn it up. So at the moment, I've only got sound coming out of the right. Nothing coming out of the left whatsoever. Let's see if that blue one is something. And I'm going to touch this to where the left should be. So blue is actually the left one. Interesting. Yeah. Final test is going to be going and putting on a left and right head test, earpiece test. I'm hearing it through both earpieces. That's not good. So right now I've got the blue connected to the left one. I'm hearing both there. I'm gonna do some research. So I found another image, and I'm not really sure if this is even correct for mine, because the one that I'm working on has a microphone, and I don't believe this has enough wires for it to be the microphone. The current cable has four or five. I think it's five, but it might actually be four. I'm still not 100% sure. But right here, it shows that the red and the gold, that those are in fact the right one is for the right ground, the gold one, and the red is the right in general. Left is just straight up green, and then the left blue, that one is your ground for the left. Then the center, so I am very confused. I've been working at this for quite a while. And I just had to desolder all the wires because I forgot to put the sleeve on, which is very frustrating. So I'm getting on that right now. It is a really tight squeeze. It's on. Man, that was a pain. Now let's get this thing underneath the microscope and get it all soldered together. So what I discovered is this little guy right here, that's ground. This is the right, and this is the left, and this is the microphone. My friend that has asked me to repair this has said, do not worry about the microphone, he never uses it. So that does save me the trouble of trying to get that wired together. It is not easy getting that one wired together. But if you look at the cables here, they are a bit of a mess now. But I have confirmed 100% that this one right here is in fact the right. Then next, you have this one right here, which I've discovered is definitely the left. Now, I thought that I needed to split up the wires that were like braided copper, the one that looks copper and red. So I've got two of these. I discovered that they're in fact both the exact same wire, which is very, very frustrating. But this one right up here, that's specifically the ground for the left headphone, while these right here are for the right. So let's get these soldered together. Now the wires have gotten to be a bit of a mess, which is unfortunate
from all my testing, I've made quite the mess of this plug, but it still is doing what it's supposed to. So let's start off first with our right. There we go. That's properly connected. And then I'm gonna throw my tweezers. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna start next. Move on to the weird ones. These tiny little grounds that I've made. The second one is now stranded up top here. Stranded in the sense that it's around it, and it's also stranded up there, as in it's been left alone on its own, abandoned. This right here is the giant ground. I'm not going to put that one in just yet. I'm going to put in this, the left feed first. There, that'll do. Those are connected. Now I'm just going to put in the ground for the left input. It's got lots of tiny little wires. That's actually, I'm pretty sure, like I was reading up on this and I was pretty sure that it was shielding. But now I've changed my mind and I'm now positive that it is not, but instead that is the microphone wires. And that would be a royal pain in the neck to try to connect. All those ground wires all together. Now to test, I can hear it from coming from both. Left is doing what it's supposed to be doing. It's nice and bassy. It's got a lot of kick. Now it's switched over to the right. Some good kick too. Let's get this all put back together. And I'm gonna have to do another test afterwards, because sometimes when you go and you put the protective sheath over the end there, it fails. Which is the most sad and terrifying thing that you can deal with, but it happens. So let's hope that doesn't happen. I gotta go and split this open so that I can get those wires through this stress reliever is what this is. This little clip at the end there is. So after you get it apart, you put the wires through and then you close it back around. I think that's doing it. This is incredibly hard. I think it's partly because I put a whole bunch of extra solder on the back there, which I hadn't intended to do, and it's making it incredibly difficult to go and get in place. But let's see what we can do. Yeah, it's that solder. It's all on the grooves there. I've really messed things up. I feel like a real idiot. That means that outright, I just gotta get this off, and then I gotta use the second one. Fortunately, there is a second one in this bag here. If there wasn't, I'd be really messed up. I was kind of thinking of using it anyways, to be honest, just because this one has been somewhat melted as I've been working on it. Okay, got a beautiful, clean, new 3.5 millimeter jack. Get some solder on it. No matter what I do, I'm going to melt plastic. There's just not enough space. It's bound to happen. I guess I could switch out which tip I'm using. This is a pretty big tip. Well, let's try our best to get these wires all in place. Let's put that nice bright red one in first. Okay, very good. That's our starting point. Now for the blue. Blue's in. And now let's get all these grounds in place. There we have it. I believe that's all of them. Time for another test. Beautiful. Both are working just as they are supposed to be. I can take these out now and get this properly wrapped up with no solder on the back this time around. I never would have thought that little bit, a little dot of solder would have caused me so much grief. I'm just putting that stress relief joint, squeezing that into place around the giant big fat cable I got going here. I'm having difficulties just getting past that silicon gasket. Gosh, this is just not working with my fingers. I can't get it to close. Come on. Nope. It's refusing. I have one solution for dealing with this when you just can't get that to close up. The part of the issue is this is a really tiny connector. That is that is my primary issue. It's a very nice connector, but it's a very tiny one. It just barely fits the size of the cables that are present with this. So I'm going to do a final test, and then I'm going to put some glue on there, some good proper glue to go and get that solidified in place. Everything's still working properly. Now, what you'd think would be a good choice for a rubberized glue, you'd think, not rubberized glue, but what you would think of using wouldn't be a rubberized glue, but you'd think instead about using maybe like crazy glue or something like that. In my case, I don't believe that is the best choice. I believe the best choice is exactly what I just said, a rubberized glue. So I'm going to fill this up with that. The rubberized glue will provide a lot of friction inside. And the reason why you want to use a rubberized glue instead of, say, a crazy glue is simply because by using a rubberized glue instead of crazy glue, if you have an issue, you can still take it back apart and fix it. If you use crazy glue, you will go crazy. You will never get it apart. It looks a little janky, I'll be honest, but it's still a very nice connector. Very frustrating repair, but guys, we've got it done. We've got them fixed. It took quite a long time for me to finish this repair, but it was very rewarding in the end, despite all the annoying problems that happened along the way. So guys, if you like the video, please do leave a like, and if you want to see more of my stuff, subscribe. Whoa! We'll see you guys all in another video. Bye!